Factoring tricks, difference of fourth powers. For this video, it's going to be important to note that the square root of x to the fourth is x squared. With fourth powers, we can use difference of squares twice. So in order to factor, we're going to have to take two steps. So we're really just going to use what we did before with difference of squares and build on top of that. So let's take a look at how this works in our first example. A to the fourth minus 16. So we just talked about the square root of something to the fourth is going to be that thing squared. And the square root of 16 is going to be 4. That's our square roots. So now we can break this down using our sum and difference of squares. Remember, in the sum and difference of squares, we're going to have two sets of parentheses. We'll have the square roots added together, and we'll have the square roots subtracted. Okay. So now, for our next step, we want to see if we can factor either of these down farther. So this one right here is a sum of squares, and sum of squares is prime. That means that we can't break it down any farther. So that one's frozen. So now let's look at this second term, a squared minus 4. So this one, a is a square, a squared is a square, and 4 is a square. So this is another difference of squares, so we can go ahead and break this down farther. We can factor it using difference of squares again. So this is now going to be the square root of a squared is a, the square root of 4 is 2, and in our second set of parentheses we'll also have a and a 2, so we'll have a plus sign and a minus sign. Now, these two, neither of these are squares, and this is going to be as far as we can break this one down. And we've still got our a squared plus 4 out in front. So our final expression will be a squared plus 4 times a plus 2 times a minus 2. So now we want to double check this and FOIL it back to make sure that we're going to get back to that original expression. So let's start out just by FOILing together our first two sets of parentheses right here. So when we FOIL these two together, we're going to multiply the first terms as a cubed, our outside terms is 2a, our inside terms is 4a, and our last term is 4 times 2 is 8. I missed a squared right here. A squared times 2 would give us 2a squared. So now we've got this whole thing times a minus 2. So now we've got to FOIL this completely together. So we want to multiply our a cubed times a will give us a to the fourth, and our 2a squared, oops, I don't want to do that one yet. Still focusing on our a cubed times 2 is going to give us minus 2a cubed. Now we'll go on to the second term. 2a squared times a will give me plus 2a cubed. 2a squared times 2 will give me minus 4. A squared. Okay, then we'll go on to this 4a, multiply that by everything. So then we'll have plus 4a, And then 4a times negative 2 will give me minus 8a. Then I'll have this 8 times absolutely everything in the second expression. So I've got 8 times a will give me plus 8a, and 8 times negative 2 will give me minus 16. So let's see which terms are going to combine when I do like terms. So for my like terms, I've got a cubed, and we've got minus 2a plus 2a, so those are going to completely subtract out. And I've got minus 4a squared. This one should also be a squared, plus 4a squared. Those two are going to completely subtract out. Minus 8a plus 8a, those will completely subtract out. And then I will just be left with a to the fourth minus 16, just like in our original expression. So now let's go ahead and take a look at example 2. So for example 2, we've got 81x to the fourth. If we took the square root of that, we need to take the square root of the number and of this x to the fourth. So the square root of the number is going to give us 9, and x to the fourth, the square root of that is going to give us x. And then the square root of 256 is going to be 16. You can double check that 16 times 16 would give you 256. And that one will be a number that we start to see around a little bit more, so it could be a good one to start to watch for. So now we want to do our difference of squares rule. So we're going to have the square roots added together, and we're going to have the square roots subtracted. And then again, we want to see whether or not we can break this down any farther. And over here, we again have a plus sign, so this is going to be the sum of squares, and it's going to be prime. And over here, we have a minus sign, so this is going to be a difference of squares, and we can keep breaking it down. So this prime one is going to stay out in front, kind of tag along. And then the second one we can divide into two more sets of parentheses using our difference of squares rule. So the square root of this is just going to be 3x. The square root of 16 is going to be 4. We'll have one that's positive and another one that is negative. Okay, so I think this time when I FOIL it back together, I'm actually going to try multiplying these two together first. And it turns out that when you're working on multiplication, it doesn't matter what order you multiply things in. So we can multiply the last ones together, and that'll be fine. So right here we've got 3x times 3x gives me 9x squared. 3x times negative 4 will give me minus 12x. And then 4 times 3x will give me plus 12x, and 4 times negative 4 will give me negative 16. So then these two terms are like terms. One of them is positive 12x, the other one's negative 12x, so those will completely go away. And I've got 9x squared plus 16 times 9x squared minus 16, what we would expect, and we can keep FOILing down, make sure we get all the way back to the original. 9x times 9x is 81x to the fourth. 9x squared times 16 is going to be minus 144x squared. 16 times 9x squared would then be our positive 144x squared, and 16 times negative 16 will give us minus 256. then we can go ahead and combine like terms. These two are exactly opposites, so they're going to subtract out, and we're left with 81x to the fourth minus 256, which is our original expression. So we have successfully factored this, and that means that this right here was our completely factored expression.